That was Gothic Vox with a tinge of urban by Kezia, and that track was called So What, available on the Little Bird album on Renaissance Records. Or you can get that. Actually, what's the name of the album? You said Little Bird. It has another
Little
name,
Bird.
Doesn't it, though? Is that right? Does it have another name?
Little Bird.
Little Bird. I thought there was an American name for it as well. But I guess my research isn't entirely correct. We've got another text for us to read out here. We've got a text from Nigel. And he's textist asking, how do I stay away from the dreaded friend zone?
Okay, dreaded friend zone is a result from usually being Mr. Nice Guy, staying in the comfort stage for too long and not managing to sexually escalate. So, how to get out of the friend zone? Let's just be friends. My Rocky's just trying to eat a wire. I'm going to pick him up. Come here, boy.
Yes, we have a live animal roaming around the studio, desperately trying to kill itself, gnawing on electrical wires. But what we were saying is...
How lovely to speak in such a way. Okay, what's this guy's name?
This is Nigel.
Nigel, okay. First of all, change your name. No, I'm only joking. I'm kidding, I'm sorry. Nigel, what
Don't
you need
cry,
to do...
Don't cry, Nigel.
Worst name. Nigel, what you need to do is you need to sexually escalate, okay, or you'll be in that friend zone because she'll just see you as some sort of a monk. Call it the monk syndrome. A lot of guys present themselves as a monk. They don't do anything. They don't show their sexual side or their sexual desire for the girl. They don't flirt. So the girl goes, oh, look, that's going to be my new best friend.
How can we avoid falling into the unfortunate let's just be friend zone?
Start flirting as soon as possible. Start flirting. You see, women love a flirt. Women actually love flirts. A lot of guys go, oh, I don't want to flirt because I'm going to come across as sleazy and creepy. So what they do is they show none of their sexual side at all because they've got such a fear of coming across as creepy. But girls never think a flirt's a creep. A flirt is unapologetically enjoying temporarily teasing the girl, turning each other on, and then just having a laugh about it after. Even something as small as that, just flirting, can stop this whole big, you know, is he gay, he's going to be just a nice guy, friend material situation. So that's my advice for Nigel, is to sexually escalate or at least start flirting. Or start, just, he has to show that he's sexual, even if he's talking about other women.
Mm.
Talking about other women that he slept with or women that he fancies, or if there's a woman that's going by, not even her, he doesn't have to direct it at her, says, oh, she's really sexy, that girl. Anything to set, like, so you don't think he's some sort of eunuch or monk.
Excellent. We've got another text in. This is from Paul Peck, and he's rather sensitive about his height, being quite a short man. What advice do you have for short men out there?
I once dated a guy who was, he was so short he had to borrow my trainers sometimes. Because I didn't see short. I saw sexy, I saw personality. If you want to sit there and just keep, you know, obsessing about your height and trying to...
Rocky's just roaming around the studio. He's fine, I don't think he'll be eating.
Okay, look, let's put it this way. Danny DeVito, when you meet Danny DeVito, people have met him, they don't sit there and go short, short, short. That's all I can think about is short. They sit there and think personality, personality. The shortness is secondary. Tom Cruise, he's fairly short. No one sits there going, that short actor. They go, oh, Tom Cruise. And a million other things come into your mind before the height. You can make, if you want, there's another option where you can make it a big joke, your height, and be the first to bring it up. But almost as in a fact that you're proud of it. There was one guy who was short that did very well with women I knew. And Rocky's doing a wee, by the way.
Oh, wonderful. We have a dog urinating live in our studio. This is a first for the Benny Casho.
Look,
we have a fluorescent... oh, he's licking it. I know he's walking around. Oh, Christ. will that soak through, do you think? It's quarter to two on the Benny Casho Show on Sunday live on radiomk.co.uk. We've got Kezia Noble with us in the studio. She's having a hoot about her enjoyable little wee-weeing dog, Rocky. if you do want to get in touch with us to ask Kezia any questions at all, please do text to 079-31-558-983. That's 079-31-558-983. Oh, we've got another text here. It says, does Kezia have a boyfriend? And if then, and if not...
Sorry about that. Yeah.
Oh, no, actually, I won't read the rest of that.
Oh, go on. I would like to read it. Let's have a look.
He's asking me to go out with you, actually. It's a kind of... No, that's very flattering. Thank you very much, mate. But yes, I suppose, yeah, because I do have a boyfriend, I suppose, is the ultimate question behind that.
I never, ever reveal.
Never reveal.
For 3 years, I haven't said whether... I could be married with 3 kids. I could be single.
Okay, that's fine. But do you ever find... this isn't specifically about that, I suppose, but do you find that your students, they might fall in love with you from time to time,
they
I
do.
Imagine. And do you find that, from an ethical stance, do you try and make yourself less attractive because you could be, I suppose, not
what
leading
them...
What
do you think? Look at me now. Do I look like I'm trying to make myself less attractive?
Well, no, my question would be that if a man was besotted with you and you were teaching, you were simultaneously his teacher as well, in order to avoid, let's say, you know, because he might just be paying for more lessons just to be around you fundamentally, do you dress down? Do you utter racial slurs? Do you try and put him off? Do you, you know, what do you do if that situation arises?
I always dress sexy. I always wear my black leather boots and skin tight clothes and my makeup done. I always do. You know, they've got to get used to that. They've got to get used to talking to a beautiful woman. A lot of them, my students come to me and they can talk to, you know, an unattractive girl, no problem. So if I'm sitting there and I've got a low-cut top on and so on, and they manage to avert their gaze and they carry on with the role play and the conversation practice that we're doing, then they're doing well. They become more... desensitized to being around a beautiful woman.
Mm-hmm.
Does that make sense? So
no, absolutely.
I'm always dressed well. I'm always wearing skin tight clothes. And I like my black dominatrix boots I wear. I'm joking, just leather black boots. Can I get on to the short question?
Yeah, go back to the short question, Kezia,
please do.
This is
very important. There's a guy that I used to know, and he was very short. And what he would do is he would be like saying something. His opening line would go up to a girl, and he'd say to her, excuse me, can you lend me a pound? I'm a bit short. And the girl would just immediately laugh, and he'd be like, you know, why are you laughing? I'm, you know, I do really well in Japan. Women love me over there. They love my size and all this stuff. And he'd actually make it his, he would turn it around and make it his strong point rather than his weak point.
Turn your weakness into a strength.
Yeah.
Ultimately. No, I like that very much, very much. Now, I'd like to discuss with you something that I have actually been perfecting myself. I'm not a... I'm also a bit of a dab hand in the game myself, and I've been developing a new style, which I think is seminal and groundbreaking, and I think could destroy all social conformities and conventions and reopen the light. I call it retail game.
Mm-hmm.
And ultimately the premise behind this is that you're in a bar or you're in a restaurant or something like that, and fundamentally you basically are bantering and teasing and flirting with the staff there, knowing that they can't go away. It's their job to be there, so you've got your time. You know, they're not going to go away, and they can't go away because they have to be there. What do you think?
I do something quite similar, actually. I do something called strip game.
Strip game?
Mm-hmm. I take my students, I take 3 to 7 students a night with a wing girl and a wing guy. And we go to a strip club, one of the top strip clubs in London, like Stringfellows or something. Sorry, he's just got a piece of paper in his mouth.
Oh, right. Again, Rocky causing all kinds of mischief on the show.
Anyway, as I was saying, let me just carry on with this.
Please do.
So... with the strip game, what it is exactly what you're doing. You've got endless women coming up to you, talking, so you can practice all your techniques in them non-stop all evening, because they're not going to go anywhere, and they're going to carry on talking to you. So if you are doing it and you can practice your game, practice your techniques on these women, in the bars and the restaurants, then great, why not?
Excellent. We've got a thumbs up for retail game. That was also co-invented by a dear friend of mine. So you know who you are, and you're probably listening to this. So we've got the confirmation we needed, mate. Let's go ahead and let's make a real go of it.